This is Pauline Jennings, and you're listening to Musician Talk. Today, my guest on Musician Talk is Mike Poot, who grew up in Rosemont and currently lives in Farmington. He started playing guitar 20 years ago when inspired by the Allman Brothers, particularly guitarist Duane Allman. Mike always had a passion for playing at home and for family and friends, but more recently, I'm happy to say, started playing in and around these parts. So we are catching this talented musician at the beginning of his professional musical career. What a treat. When Mike's not playing, he enjoys coaching his daughter's softball teams and hunting with his three bird dogs. It's time to get to know him better. Let's talk to Mike Poot. Hi, Mike. Welcome.
Good morning.
Welcome to Musician Talk. I'm so happy to have you here.
Thank you for having me.
You know, I'm really excited, not only because of the weather. The sun is shining in the window here at the studio, so it's beautiful. But also, you're going to be playing live today, which is really exciting. First time for Musician Talk. So thanks for being brave, too.
You're very welcome.
You know, I start usually with talking about the personal musical journey of my guest. And so I want you to start us off when you first started playing 20 years ago and kind of, or as a child, whenever you did, and whatever instrument you started on, and take us through to now. Let's go ahead and synopsize that in 10 minutes.
Yeah. I guess my passion for music started when I was pretty young, probably the third grade. I remember me and a buddy, we would, at the end of class, we'd rap the Beastie Boys.
Nice.
In school. And, so since then, you know, I always listened to music a lot growing up, and I was probably in my early 20s, maybe 19. I had some buddies go to, Duluth to go to school. And I saw a guy up there named Paulie, and, he was playing guitar, and I thought that was just one of the coolest things ever. And so I made a comment to my mom one day, and I don't even remember making the comment. And she went to a horse auction. And she came back with this guitar case, like, here, I got you this guitar at this horse auction. I was like, well, Ma, I don't know how to play guitar. She's like, oh, you'll figure it out, you know.
And wow.
So I opened up the case, and there's a book in there on how to, you know, play guitar and make the shapes to play chords. And so I'm doing that for a few weeks, and it just sounds terrible. So I decided to go back to page one of the book where it teaches you how to tune a guitar. And I was like, oh, that might be something I want to do. So I tuned it, and then I was doing the chord shapes with my fingers, and like, oh, that actually sounds like something. It's starting to make sense now. And
it's hilarious.
So I'd sit out on my front step pretty much every day and just play and just learn. And my buddies would come over, and they would make fun of me about it. Like, oh, what are you going to do? Like, they weren't fans. And about a year later, I had figured out a few songs, and pretty soon all my buddies are going and buying guitars and asking me to show them how to play. So that was early on. And I played in a band with a guy named Jamie Watton, who plays with Bitter Roots, and he writes a lot of great original tunes right now, and he's got an album coming out. But there was a time in there where life got busy, and I set my guitar down for probably about 8 years. And one day I just picked it up, and I had my daughter there, and she was singing, and I had a neighbor who liked to sing, so I'd, you know, try to learn some songs there, and then I fell back in love with playing guitar, and I just started playing more and more and more.
I find it interesting, people like you who pick up a guitar or any instrument and just start playing without any lessons, but more so that you stick with it, because all of us that take lessons or don't take lessons and pick up an instrument, there comes a point when it becomes difficult. And, you know, maybe it starts out pretty easy, and you have to push through that to get to the next phase. How did you do that? Do you remember that? Did it happen to you?
I'm still sitting on that plateau right now. I think it's just, for me, it was the passion of wanting to play and enjoying what I'm doing and hearing, like, the guitar. And there's something about just grabbing a chord on guitar and maybe even just playing it once and just loving the sound of that.
Wow.
So it's perseverance for sure, frustration. Mm-hmm. Go through times where, you know, I say, man, I'm not good enough.
whoever is, really.
Right.
I mean, that's the thing about art and music is that you're never perfect. Yeah. And that's the beauty of it. You always can be better. You always could work harder to get better or to be able to play different styles and all that kind of thing. Okay, so you have two daughters?
Yes, yeah. Bella and Sammy.
I have a Sam.
Oh.
Yes.
So, yeah, Bella's 13 and Sammy is 11.
Oh, what wonderful ages.
Yeah.
I love those ages. People warn you away from those ages with girls, but I love them.
Me too.
Oh, good.
I tried to get Belle to come with me to sing some backups, but
she gets
pretty nervous.
Well, maybe when she gets a little older and gets over that, we'll have you back and she can sing.
That would be wonderful.
And what do they think about this?
They think I'm famous.
That's what we want our kids to think about us, isn't it?
And they're very supportive. And I had some Mike Poot t-shirts made and sweatshirts, and they wear them every day.
That is so sweet. I think my kids, when they were growing up and I was in shows and playing in bands, it was just ho-hum. I mean, just so ho-hum. Yeah. You know? It was so wet. That's what mom does. But so that's really, really cool. And that the older one is singing with you?
Yeah, she'll sing with me once in a while, and then she'll sing on her own, and she'll play piano and keyboard, and she's kind of just going through what I went through when I was learning, and just you're kind of figuring it out on your own, and she practices pretty much daily.
And, have you taken any lessons?
Over the years, there's been a few here and there. Never really stuck with them much. A lot of it's just been on my own.
I think sometimes when you are proficient enough to be able to play well and accompany yourself and all that, you can learn on your own. But to have lessons at certain critical points when you're trying to get over or learn something specific. My husband's been playing for 50 whatever years or 40. What I don't know, that's a long time, and he still takes lessons, you know, periodically, maybe every couple years, and just to learn something new or something that he's, trying to learn. So that's really cool. I want to turn to the first song that you're going to play, and just so everybody knows, we're gonna set the levels after he starts playing. So because we're doing this live, and it's the first time I've done it. So anyway, we're going to play a song called "Stone" by Whiskey Myers.
Yeah,
and I want to know why you chose that song to play here today.
It's a song that I just love. The song, I love what it's about, and you know, it talks about your heart turning to stone, and it's not always maybe a significant other, but there's so many people in your life that you love, and relationships can change, whether it's family, friends, and it just there can be heartbreak with things associated other than just significant others.
Yeah. Oh gosh, isn't that true?
Yeah.
Absolutely. And what about this Whiskey Myers? I listened to this cover. I love his voice. I actually love the song, too. Do you do a lot of Whiskey Myers songs?
Yeah, I do quite a few. Yeah. And a lot of the stuff that I listen to is people that are playing and they're not on the radio. They're out gaining popularity on their own.
That's cool.
Yeah.
That's really cool. Because the tendency is to want to play what people know so that they'll – to please them.
You think
–
Yeah, I don't do that too much.
That is great. Okay, well, Mike, why don't you go ahead and play Stone for us, please?
The night is my companion. I'm seeking for one last beacon. Every single place I roam, they said Jesus was a poor man. Wish I had a little more of him in me. Is this too far gone?
Well, I guess I got my bottle. I stay on it all the time. But it keeps me smiling and singing. Helps me fall asleep a little bit better at night. They say life is like a dagger. Backstage is full of parasites. They'll love you and drain you everything you want, just to feel better about their lives. A sweet, sweet autumn mine, I'm gonna break again a million times.
Pauline Jennings, the host of Musician Talk. Today, my guest is Mike Poot, and you just heard him perform live in the KYMN studio, Stone, a Whiskey Myers cover. Wow, that was terrific.
Thank you.
Now, I had asked you to be on the show without ever hearing you perform, and I'm so pleased. I'm really, really pleased. I love the quality of your voice, that gruffness, but yet there's a little bit of a smoothness that kind of cuts through, particularly when you go high. And yeah, nicely done.
Yeah, those notes are high.
They are
high.
High
for me.
And you're hitting them, no problem. You're just hit them right in the center. That's great. Thank you so much for doing that. You sounded great. So, musical influences. You wrote me a handful of them. The Allman Brothers, Duane Allman, Tyler Childers, Whiskey Myers. Tell me a little bit more. You say that you picked songs from up-and-coming artists, not necessarily people that have been popular for a long time. So tell me a little bit about your influences.
Yeah, I guess it started back, you know, early on was the Allman Brothers band, and the guitar playing of Duane Allman is just out of this world. It is amazing. And I could listen to a 10-minute guitar solo and be perfectly content. So that was a really big influence. When I first started playing, and more recently, just I don't listen to the radio a lot. I like to find songs that are, you know, just simple words can really move me and mean something. And you don't always get that in the huge music, the big market.
Mm-hmm.
So yeah, like guys like Tyler Childers and Whiskey Myers and, you know, even Chris Stapleton, who's gained a ton of popularity, just their songwriting and what they're singing about, for me, it just hits me.
Okay, so you kind of went into how you choose songs as well as your influences. So let's go ahead and talk about that. Well, first of all, I want to ask you, now that you play guitar, is listening to those Duane Allman solos different? Or is it pretty much the same?
I think the feeling there, the motion has always been there, but if I have to concentrate on something, I can't listen to music now. Because it spins in my head and I'm like picturing a guitar or where they are in the fretboard and like the intervals of the notes. And like, I just can't do it. I get so distracted.
If it's piano, let's just say it's piano and voice. Does that happen?
Yeah.
Like pretty much anything.
Oh, yeah.
Not just guitar.
Yeah, it's the intervals of the notes and just how they fit together. And I mean, I lay in bed at night and songs just play in my head sometimes for hours.
Wow. Wow. Well, passion is, music is a passion for you. And obviously that invades every part of your life, right? So when you pick songs, or how do you actually pick songs? So you listen, you look for songs that hit you in the heart. Is there any other criteria as far as the difficulty of playing, the type of music, if it's blues or jazz or rock?
It could be probably any genre. Boy, it's the feel I get from the song.
Yeah.
Like a lot of the songs I play aren't on the radio. There's definitely some that are.
Sure.
But I try to give people something that they're not seeing the same top 40 songs played in a bar and just kind of like on repeat.
Right.
I don't know if you heard it in that song there, but I was playing, I felt like I was playing quiet.
Oh.
And so when I play, I go hard, I guess. I don't, right. I put everything into it every time I play.
I am excited to come and see you play. That sounds like a great experience to do. All right, so let's talk a little bit about the importance of music. I mean, I think we've covered on it a little bit in general. And I think it's so great that you're introducing your daughters to music. I think I would like you to speak to the importance of that for you.
I think it just gives you... It's for me, it's different than anything else that I do in my life. I could be alone and enjoy it as much then as if I'm playing with a few buddies and we're just having fun or putting on a show for people. The feeling for me is generally the same. It's just I just feel happy. I feel relaxed. I can forget about, you know, everything that's going on in the world. The last couple of years has been challenging for everyone.
Yeah, no
and kidding. you can step back and take a break.
Yeah.
And breathe.
Yeah. So you're giving your daughters that opportunity to have something in their life that they can breathe with.
Absolutely. Yeah.
How about in like society as a whole, you could say that same thing about it. It gives everybody a chance to breathe. Is there anything else that comes to mind to you about the importance of music and maybe art in general, but because it is different from other things we do in our lives?
There's really no rules.
Ah.
There's no,
nice.
There's guidelines, sure, and you know, there's way musical tones or tones work together, but the sky's the limit on creativity, and I think we lose out on that a lot when we're all waking up in the morning, going to work, going home. We're kind of just, I feel like sometimes we get stuck on repeat every day.
Yep.
And if you can take some time out of your day to, you know, listen to a song and reflect about how you're feeling or what's going on in your life, it might help you help someone else eventually.
That's great. That's beautiful. I like that. It really is cool. The no rules thing. And, I mean, you go outside of Western music, you know, Eastern music, there's different scales.
Yeah.
I mean, so the rules really go out the window. That's really cool. Let's talk about the second song. And this is Tyler Childers' cover, Universal Sound. Can you tell me a little bit about why you picked this one? Anyway, you like it, what it's about, those things.
I think it hits kind of what we were just talking about how you can pause and listen and internalize, you know, how you're feeling. And you could do that. A lot of people do it through music. Music can explain and help you understand why you're feeling a certain way, or maybe there's something in your life that you're going through that a song can just hit home. And I think this song, he's sitting back and he's just listening and he's thinking and he's focusing on himself. And, you know, self-care is very, very important.
Mm-hmm.
And I'd never really thought about it until I'd met Haley. And
Haley is here in the studio with us. Yes. Hello, Haley.
Hi, Haley. And just, you know, the importance of taking care of yourself. And in this song, I think that's what it's about.
Awesome. Please
ready?
Play. Yep.
Up in Pocahontas, near the Cranberry Glades, ain't got balls, tore the charge collar anyways. 9 miles a mile a minute, my thoughts bark like hounds. I focus on my breathing and the universal sound. I think about my darling girl sleeping all alone. I pray the stars shoot her all the wishes she can hold. On the day that I return, I aim to lay her down. But right now I'm focused on the universal sound. Jars shine. I think about my vices that let take me over time. nothing around but a little bitty rattler and the universal sound. And I closed my eyes. It was all so clear. It was all right then. It was all right here. I focus on my breathing and the universal sound. I let it take me over from the toenails to the crown. This body that I'm in, they can put me in the ground. I'll return to the chorus, the universal sound. And I closed my eyes, and it was all so clear. It was all right then, it was all right here. I've been up on the mountain, I've seen his wondrous grace. I sat there on a bar stool and I looked him in the face. He seemed a little haggard, but it did not slow him down. He was humming to the neon of the universal sound.
This is Pauline Jennings, and you're listening to Musician Talk. My guest, Mike Poot, just played Tyler Childers' cover, Universal Sound, live for us right here at KYMN. Okay, that song, I love it. I was writing down lyrics. It's like it should be part of the show, because it kind of describes a lot of what I want to get to at this show, which is, it is universal, yeah. That need for music. A baby with the rattle that's so appealing to them. With that, you're already starting your little beats, right?
Right.
And that, it's just such a beautiful sentiment, and you sing it really, really well.
Thank you.
And I kind of feel like I saw you go into the zone a little bit there. You know, okay, forget I'm on a radio show. I'm now just playing music and singing, and I saw it. It was like a transformation, a little letting go. That's really, really cool. Yeah. So, where have you been playing?
I played down at Froggy Bottoms last weekend, right here in Northfield. I like that place a lot. It's that the basement there is very, very cozy, and it's a good place to play. Play at Buck 54 at Buck Hill coming up this Friday, and then Grocer's Table in Wayzata on Saturday. They are just starting to have live music over there. So,
and where's that?
Grocer's Table's in Wayzata.
Oh, that's a ways.
So, yeah, okay. Me and my buddy Justin, we're kicking off their live music.
That is
so
really cool.
They've never had it before. And
how are you getting gigs?
I use Facebook a lot.
Yeah?
Messenger, and I message bars, and I send a lot of messages, and you get a lot of no's, but I get some yeses in there, too.
Do a lot of them ask to hear you for recording?
Sometimes. Yeah. Okay. And then other times I'll just stop in person and drop off a card. And I've even brought my guitar with me and like, hey, I'll audition right now.
That's a really great idea. They won't forget you then.
That's right.
It's not
that's
just
right.
an email coming into their box with something else to listen to.
Yeah. Yeah.
So I was just going to continue to talk about the gigs. So you use Facebook and you visit places. How much do you want to work? How much playing music? How much do you want to gig?
Every Friday and Saturday.
You do.
And Sunday afternoon.
Wow. You're ready to just hit.
I love doing it.
I can tell.
And it's not for the money. It's not for, I don't know, like if some people would say fame or whatever. I really, really enjoy doing it. And I like playing for new people who haven't heard what I play. And they're like, we don't know any of these songs, but we love it.
Yeah.
And you know, and you can always kind of judge an audience on how many claps you get. And it's love the songs where we get one clap. And it's usually the guy in the back. And like It breaks my heart sometimes, but in a good way.
That's good. You keep it positive. That's really great. I just lost my thought. I'm sorry. Let's talk about best gig, worst gig, and maybe I can recapture what I was going to ask because it was really a good question, I'm sure.
Sure. Yeah, my best and worst gig were actually the same one.
Oh, no.
And they were, it was about 3 weeks ago, I had a buddy pass away. And his wife asked me to play at his celebration of life. And my immediate answer was yes. But this was a very good friend and a very good person. And the challenge of having to set aside my emotions for what was going on and play it, a couple songs like that were really, really, really for other people. And so they could, you know, mourn the loss. And I think when I played it, it like everything I had in me came out. And so that was the worst and best feeling that I've had.
Yeah, I've done that as well. It's really a difficult thing to do. And particularly, well, I guess if you can't sing anymore, at least you got your guitar there, because sometimes, right, it's you can't. So I'm very sorry to hear about your friend.
Thank you.
That's tough. And it's so tough to play those gigs. Okay, I've done many funerals and I've done many weddings. Totally different thing, obviously. But in some way, there's some similarities because you're playing for the people in the congregation for whatever mood that you need to be playing it. But to do my grandmother's was so difficult. But whenever I couldn't sing, the guitar would take over. And that's so nice that you have that instrument there.
Yeah.
And some safety in that.
Yes, absolutely. Yep.
And so, you know, when you prepare a song or pick songs for, I'm just going to get back to the picking the songs idea, for a big band or a band with a drummer and a bass player and all that, probably the choices are a little different from just your guitar. So when you hear a song by, let's say, Whiskey Myers, and it's got the full complement of musicians in there, what do you do with it to make it okay just on acoustic?
I think that's where I rely on my voice and like the emotion that I can put into a song and really just use the feeling that I have inside to let that ring out when I'm playing a song on just an acoustic guitar. And I think there's songs, you know, that you can't just do on an acoustic guitar either. You know, you need the full band.
Right.
And I'd say an acoustic gig, you know, you're not really going to have people up there dancing a lot of the time. So you want it to be good to listen to for them if they're still going to have a conversation and maybe you're somewhat background noise. And the full band, I mean, you're probably rocking at that point in time. You got people out dancing and having a good time.
Right. So. Well, that's what you hope when you're in the band anyway. Yeah. Keep them on the dance floor. That's so key.
That's right. That's right.
Well, it's so obvious that your passion for music just is pouring out of everything that you say. And I think that there's very, very few people that can do this and make a living. I mean, it's a tough gig. My husband does, and it's tough. I mean, it's just you got your hands in everything and you're kind of constantly going. So the passion is coming through and it's obvious that you're doing it because of that. It would also be nice to be able to do it for a living.
Absolutely. Yeah.
So those of you out there that just heard them and have some projects you want people working on, that would be great. Where can people find you if they want you either to play at their place, at their restaurant or bar?
Yeah. So I'm terrible at self promotion. It's just, but Haley helps me out a lot. And I've got a Facebook page. If you search Mike Poot Music on Facebook, it should take you to my page.
Okay.
It's not a real common name. So,
right. You're not going to get a bunch of Mike Poots popping up.
That's right. Yeah. That's right.
So you're playing Friday at Buck Hill.
Yep.
And Saturday at Grocer's Table up in Wayzata. Are there any other gigs coming up? Anything in the area, like in the next month or two? While you look at that, I'm going to just say that I'm just so, so happy to have had you on the show. You sounded great. I am so happy that you agreed to play live here. And I want to let the audience know that next week is my 50th show. So you're at 49, which actually is almost better because that's made up of 2 7s, which are prime numbers, which I like.
Well, congratulations for both.
Thank you. Both of them.
So yeah, we got Buck on Friday, Grocer's Table Saturday. I'll be back at Froggy Bottoms on March 13th.
Perfect.
That's a Sunday show. And I'm out in New Germany on March 26th at Down South Bar and Grill.
And March 13th, what time are you playing at Froggy's?
Looks like 1 to 3.
All right, I'm going to try to make that gig. And I encourage everybody out there listening to do the same, to hear some more of this beautiful singing and guitar playing. That's really wonderful. So I guess we're going to wrap this up. And look up Mike Poot on Facebook if you want more information about him, or if you want to contact him through Messenger, right? Anything else you want to say?
I just really appreciate the opportunity to come down here and be on the radio. You don't get this opportunity very often, and I really appreciate you reaching out and asking me. I'm glad we made it work.
I'm glad we did too. Thank you. Bye-bye.
Bye.
So many thanks to Mike for joining me today and for agreeing to play live on air. What fun. Also, I am so grateful to you for listening to Musician Talk on the One, KYMN. You have a terrific day.